In the last tutorial, we were discussing about probability. And in the last class, we already learned about the basic concept of probability, conditional probability, multiplication theorem, dependent and independent events. Now we have to do some practical question based on multiplication theorem of the probability and conditional probability. Now after that we will start the total probability and Bayes theorem. Now let's see one very important question from multiplication theorem and independent event. The question is probability of solving specific problem independently by A and B are 1/2 and 1/3 respectively. Right? If both are trying to solve the problem independently, find the probability that first part, the problem is solved, and second part exactly one of them solves the problem. Very important question from 2011 board examination. The probability of solving a specific problem independently by A and B. So we have two events in this. Problem solved by A, this is event A, and problem solved by B, this is event B. We have two events here. Event A, problem solved by A. Event B, problem solved by B. Right? Now let's consider two events, event A and event B. Event A, problem solved by A. And event B, problem solved by B. Right? Now, in the first part, we have to find the problem is solved, and the question it is already given that these events are independent events. Now, if two events are independent events, so second event is not depend on first. Means we can say that the problem solved by B is not depend on problem solved by A. Let's say we have a problem, and there are two candidates solving both the problem, but both solving independently. The question is, if A solves the problem, B does not solve. If B solves the problem, A does not solve, then it will be the dependent event. But in this case, we have independent event. So how can we solve this one? First part, the problem is solved. Let's see from a Venn diagram. If we have a question like this, exactly one of them, both of them, A and B. You can draw a Venn diagram for this. Let's see, there are two events A and B. And the question, first part is, the problem, find the probability of the problem is solved. Problem is solved means either A can solve the problem, or B can solve the problem, or both of them can solve the problem. Problem is solved means at least one of them will solve the problem. Both are same thing. Problem is solved means at least one of them will solve the problem. Means we can say that either exactly A can solve the problem or exactly B or both can solve the problem. So in the first case, we have to find probability of A union B. We have to find the probability of A union B. Means A or B solve the problem. Remember the formula we learnt in class 11, probability of A union B equal to probability of A plus probability of B minus probability of A intersection B. Now, probability of A plus probability of B. And what do we mean by probability of A intersection B in the case of independent event? In the last class, we discussed about this. In the case of independent event, probability of A intersection B can be written as probability of A multiplied probability of B. Why? Because event B does not depend on event A. Right? Now, put the values. Probability of A will be given 1 by 2 and B 1 by 3 minus 1 by 2 multiplied 1 by 3. Simplify this. 1 by 2 plus 1 by 3 minus 1 by 6. After getting 6 as LCM, we get 3 plus 2 minus 1. 3 plus 2, 5 minus 1, 4 by 6. It will be 2 by 3. So first part is 2 by 3. Now second part. Second part we have find the probability that exactly one of them solve the problem. Exactly one of them means either exactly A or exactly B can solve the problem. Exactly one of them will solve the problem. Exactly one of them. How can we find this one? Means we have to find probability of A exactly A or exactly B. Exactly A or exactly B. According to Venn diagram, we have to find this one. So we can say that it will be probability of A union B minus A intersection B. According to Venn diagram, we can say that it will be probability of A union B minus probability of A intersection B. Now you know probability of A union B is what? 2 by 3. And A intersection B 1 by 6. We need to simplify this. After getting 6 as LCM, it will be 4 minus 1. That is 3 by 6, 1 by 2. 1 by 2 is the answer to the second part. Exactly one of them solve the problem is either exactly A or exactly B can solve the problem. Right? Very simple question. Now we can solve the question related to independent event and dependent event, multiplication theorem and conditional probability. Right? Now we'll move to the total probability and Bayes theorem. Very important part in the probability. And especially Bayes theorem is very important for long answer type question. Right? Now, first of all, we have to discuss about the law of total probability. The law of total probability. What do we mean by the law of total probability? Let's see if we have sample space like this. This is sample space. Do you know what is the probability of sample space? Probability of sample space will be 1 always. Probability of sample space will be 1. Right? Now, let's see in sample space we have n events. We have n events. Event E1. Many events are there. Event E1. We have event E2. We have event E3. And so on up to event En. Let's see, we have many events. And according to this diagram, the events E1, E2, E3 and so on up to En are mutually exclusive and exhaustive event. What do we mean by exclusive and exhaustive? Mutually exclusive events means probability of E1 intersection E2 is equal to 0. There is no common part between E1 and E2. There is no common part between E2 and E3. There is no common part between E3 and E4. There is no common part between E1, E2, E3, E4 and so on up to En. That is called the exclusive event. And what do you mean by exhaustive event? Exhaustive event means the sum of probability of each event will be equal to 1. means we can say that probability of E1 plus probability of E2 and so on plus probability of EN is equal to 1. That will be equal to sample space, right? So let E1, E2, E3 and so on up to EN are mutually exclusive and exhaustive event. And exhaustive events, right? Exclusive means what? Means we can say that therefore we can say that E1 intersection E2 intersection E3 and so on up to intersection EN is equal to 5. And exhaustive means probability of E1 plus probability of E2 plus probability of E3 and so on up to probability of EN is equal to 1. For example, if a fair die is thrown, a die is thrown, two events are there. Probability of getting even number, second, probability of getting odd number. Probability of getting even number, probability of getting odd number, both are exhaustive and exclusive event. Because even number and odd number, there is no common part between them. So even intersection E2 is 5 and the probability of even plus probability of E2 is equal to 1. The probability of getting even number 3 by 6 and getting odd number 3 by 6, it will be 1. So we have to consider this type of event in which E1, E2 and so on up to EN are exclusive and exhaustive event. Now, we have to consider one single element, single event A. Let's consider we have an element A and we have an element A such that we have an event A such that there must be some common part between A and E1, A and E2, A and E3 and so on up to EN. Right? Now, so we can say that this will be A intersection E1. This can be written as A intersection E2. This can be written as A intersection E3. And so on up to this can be written as A intersection EN. Right? We have to find the probability of A. Probability of event A can be written as probability of A can be written as probability of A intersection E1 plus probability of A intersection E2 and so on plus probability of A intersection EN. Right? Probability of A, this is called the probability of A. Probability of A means what? A divided into N parts. A divided into n parts. First part is called A intersection E1, second part is A intersection E2 and so on. Now how can we simplify? Probability of A is equal to, now A and E1 both are dependent event. A and E1 are what? Dependent event. These are not independent. E1 is based on A. A is dependent on E1. Now therefore probability of A can be written in the case of dependent event. You know A intersection E1 can be written as probability of E1 multiply probability of A by E1. Probability of A intersection E2 can be written as probability of E2 multiply probability of A by E2. And so on up to probability of A by intersection EN can be written as probability of EN multiply probability of A by EN. Right? This is called the total probability. Probability of A is called the total probability and this is the formula to find the total probability. Right? Now, Bayes theorem is depend on this. Now, let's see what is Bayes theorem. And which type of question can be asked in total probability and Bayes theorem? Let's see about the total probability. In total probability, let's see an example. If we have two bags. Before starting the Bayes theorem, let's see we have two bags. bag 1 and bag 2, bag A and bag B, two bags are there. And let's consider in bag A we have 5 red and 2 black balls, and in this bag we have 4 red and 3 black balls, right? Now the question is, a bag is selected at random and find a ball. A bag is selected at random and find a ball. Find the probability of getting the ball is a red ball. Right? So first we have to decide the event E1, E2 and event A. In this case, event E1 is probability of getting first bag is event E1. Probability of getting second bag is event E2. And probability of getting a red ball is event A. Right? We have to find the probability of getting a red ball, which we have to find the probability of A. We can write probability of E1 multiply A by E1 plus E2 multiply A by E2, E1 for first bag and E2 for second bag. And here, if we have two bags, what is the probability of getting the first bag out of 2? 1 by 2. And probability of getting second bag out of 2? 1 by 2. You will get probability of E1 is 1 by 2 and probability of E2 is 1 by 2. And what about A by E1? This is the conditional probability. A by E1 means probability of getting a red ball if first bag is selected. Red ball if first bag is selected. This event is already occurred, then we have to find the probability of this event. We can find this one. So, we can find in this the probability of getting a red ball, that is called probability of A. This we have to find. What about E1, E2? E1 is getting first, selecting first bag and selecting second bag. Selecting first bag, and event E2 is what? Selecting second bag. And event A is what? Selecting a red ball. But we have to find probability of A. This will be probability of E1 multiply probability of A by E1 and plus probability of E2 and multiply probability of A by E2. What is the question exactly? The question is, two bags containing 5 red and 2 black ball and 4 red and 3 black ball respectively. A bag is selected at random and then found a ball from the bag. Find the probability that the selected ball will be the red ball. Selected ball will be the red ball. This we have to find. So probability of E1 is 1 by 2. Why? Selecting first bag out of 2. And what is the probability of E2? 1 by 2. Now E1 and E2 are independent event and their sum is 1. Probability of E1 plus probability of E1 E2 must be equal to 1 according to this concept. Right? Now, what do we mean by A by E1? A by E1 is selecting, we have to convert this into language statement. Convert this into statement. What is the statement for this A by E1? The statement is find the probability of getting a red ball, probability of getting a red ball when first bag is selected. First bag is already selected. What is the probability of getting red ball? So probability of getting red ball in the first bag will be 5 by 7. 5 by 7. Probability of getting a red ball if second bag is selected. What is this probability? 4 by 7. Now the answer will be 5 plus 4 by 14, that is 9 by 14 is the answer. Probability of total probability. Now this is called the total probability. Very important question. Now the Bayes theorem is also based on the total probability. And Bayes theorem is also called the converse probability. If we have a conditional probability A by E1, then E1 by A is called the converse probability of that, right? Now the very important part in the probability, which is Bayes theorem. create very important part. Now Bayes theorem we also call converse probability. If we have conditional probability A by E1 and A by E2, so E1 by A and E2 by A is called the converse probability. See, just the opposite. In this question, we have P A by E1, which is called probability of getting a red ball when first bag is selected. And what is the opposite of this? What do you mean by E1 by A? Find the probability of getting first bag if it is given that red ball is selected. After selecting the red ball, find the probability of getting a first bag. Find the probability of getting a second bag. That will be called E1 by A and E2 by A. Right? In the Bayes theorem again, let E1, E2 and so on up to En are exclusive and exhaustive events, right? Then we have to find the probability of En by A. We have to find the probability of Ei by A. I may be 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on up to N, right? Yes. Now Ei by A we have to find. How can we find this one? This is nothing but the conditional probability. We can write this one PEI intersection A divided by probability of A. By conditional probability of formula of conditional probability, probability of A by B is equal to probability of A intersection B divided by probability of B, right? Now, by conditional probability, probability of EI by A will be probability of EI intersection A by probability of A. Now simplify. Therefore, probability of EI by A is equal to, what do you mean by EI intersection A? By dependent event, it will be probability of EI multiplied probability of A by EI by dependent event multiplication theorem. And what do you mean by probability of A? Probability of A, this is the law of total probability. We discussed in the last topic. Probability of A will be probability of E1 multiplied A by E1 plus probability of E2 multiply probability of A by E2 and so on up to probability of En and multiply probability of A by En. It depends how many events are there. This is called the Bayes theorem. By this formula we can find the converse probability. If we have to find probability of E2 by A, then it will be probability of E2 multiply A by E2 and E1 A by E1 plus E2 A by E2. First we have decide E1, E2, E3 and so on up to En and even A. Then we can apply the Bayes theorem. Now the very important part in Bayes theorem, how can we decide? This is the question based on Bayes theorem or conditional probability. How can we decide this? Either this is the question based on conditional probability, independent event or Bayes theorem or total probability. This is very important part in the probability. How can you decide the concept used in this, right? Now, let's see the first question. We will discuss some important example in Bayes theorem. Then we will be able to solve, able to select the question based on this topic, right? Now, the first one, a very simple question from Bayes theorem. An insurance company, insured 2000 scooter drivers. 2000 scooter drivers, 4000 car drivers and 6000 truck drivers. right? The probabilities, the probabilities of an accident, the probability of an accident are 0.01, 0.03 and 0.15 respectively. One of the insured persons meets with an accident . What is the probability that he is a scooter driver? What is the probability that he is a scooter driver? Now the question is, an insurance company insured the 2000 scooter drivers, 4000 car drivers and 6000 truck drivers. The probability of an accident are 0.01, 0.03 and 0.15 respectively. One of the person, insured person meets with an accident, what is the probability that he is a scooter driver? Now first of all, how can you decide this is the question based on which theorem? What you have to find? You have to find the probability of one of the events, which events are already given. Means in this case, we have to find the probability of either E1, E2, E3 and so on up to EN if there are many events. So in this question, we have three events. The selected person is a scooter driver, the selected person is a car driver and the selected person is a truck driver. Three events are there. And we have to find the probability of a scooter driver. We have to find the probability of one of the events from event E1, E2, E3 up to EN. This we have to find one of the events. But it is given that something already given. What we have to give? Given that one of the insured person meets with an accident. This is called the event A, meets with an accident. So what we have to find, how can we decide the events? Here, event E1, event E2, and event E3. Three events are there and with event A. What is event A? Which is already given. Event A is given. What is given? If one person meets with an accident, the person meets with an accident is called event A. A person meets with an accident is called event A. And what is event E1? Selected person is a scooter driver. Second, selected person is a car driver. Third one, selected person is a truck driver. Now what we have to find? We have to find the probability of E1 by A. What we have to find? Find the probability of scooter driver. This probability E1. If it is given that he meets with an accident, we have to find E1 by A. So what? What is the formula for E1 by A? It will be probability of E1 multiplied probability of A by E1 and divided by probability of E1 multiplied probability of A by E1 and plus probability of E2 multiplied probability of A by E2. There are only three events are there. E2 and plus probability of E3 multiplied probability of A by E3. Three events are there. Right? You can write by Bayes theorem, we can apply this formula. Now what do you mean by probability of E1? Probability of E1, selected person is scooter driver. How many total drivers are there? 2000, 4000, 4 plus 6 plus 12,000 are there. So probability of E1 will be probability of E1 will be 2000 by 12,000. What is the probability of E2? E2 means car driver. It will be 4000 by 12,000. What we mean by event E3? E3 will be 6000 divided by 12,000. These are the events E1, E2, and E3. And the sum of all the three events must be equal to 1. So E1 will be 1 by 6, 1 by 3, and 1 by 3. All together it will be 1. Now, so probability E1 will be 1 by 6 multiplied. A by E1 already given. The person meets with an accident. What do you mean by A1? A by E1. A by E1 is called probability meets with an accident if he is a scooter driver. This is called A by E1. The person meets with an accident if he is a scooter driver. So how many scooter drivers meet with an accident? 0.01 divided by 1 by 6 multiplied 0.01 plus probability E2 will be 1 by 3 multiplied 0.03. This one and plus 1 by 2 multiplied 0.15. After simplification, you will get the exact answer. If you simplify this, you will get the exact answer by 12. Very important question for 6 marks. Right? Now we have to do some more question based on Bayes' theorem. Now let's see. Yeah, we can solve some more question if E1, E2, E3 are given but not in numerical value. Given in the statement value. It may be impossible event, it may be sure event, right? Very important question. In answering a question, on a multiple choice question test, MCQ test, multiple choice question test, a student either know the answer or guess the answer. Let 3 by 4 be the probability that he know the answer. Probability already given. And 1 by 4 be the probability that he guesses the answer. Assuming that very good student, 3 by 4 for the know the answer and 1 by 4 guessing the answer. Very good student. Assuming that student who guesses the answer will be correct with probability 1 by 4. What is the probability that? The student know the answer know the answer, given that he answered it correctly. He answered it correctly. He answered it correctly.
What is the question there?
First, we have to see the last line. What is the probability that a student knows the answer? This we have to find. And we have two events according to first line. We have two events. In answering a question on a multiple choice test, a student either knows the answer or guesses the answer. So we have two events. Event E1 is what? A student, selected student, knows the answer. And second event E2, the selected student guesses the answer. So we have to find the probability he knows the answer. We have to find the probability of E1. If it is given that the he answered it correctly. This is answer is correct. What do you mean by event A here? Event A, his answer is correct. He answered it correctly. This is answer is correct. Answer is correct in event A. What we have to find in this? We have to find the probability of E1 by A. According to question, let's see. Find the probability that the student knows the answer E1, given that he answered it correctly, event A. We have to find the probability of E1 by A. We can apply Bayes' theorem to find this. To find the probability of E1 by A, we will get E1 multiply A by E1 divided by probability of E1 multiply probability of A by E1 and plus probability of E2 and multiply probability of A by E2. Right? Now, first we have to find probability of E1, probability of E2, probability of A by E1 and probability of A by E2. Then we can put the value. We have to find the probability of these four events. What do you mean by E1? Probability of a student knows the answer. Already given. Probability of he knows the answer 3 by 4 and the probability of he guesses the answer 1 by 4. So probability of E1 can be written as 3 by 4 and the probability of E2 can be written as 1 by 4. Now what do you mean by A by E1? A by E1 is called probability of his answer is correct if he knows the answer, and A by E2 means what? Probability of his answer is correct if he guesses the answer. This is already given. Assuming that a student he guesses the answer will be correct with probability 1 by 4. His answer is correct when he guesses the answer. His answer is correct when he guesses the answer is 1 by 4. Already given. His answer is correct. If it is given that he guesses the answer, the probability is 1 by 4. What do you mean by A by E1? What do you mean by A by E1? Probability of the student's answer is correct if he knows the answer. A by E1 is what? His answer is correct when he knows the answer. His answer is correct when he knows the answer. His answer is correct when he knows the answer is a sure event and probability is 1. Understood? The probability of his answer is correct when he knows the answer. If he knows the answer, means his answer must be correct. This is sure event and the probability of sure event is what? 1. So now we can apply the formula. The very important part in this question, this is sure event. This is understood but not exactly given in the question. E2 is 1 by 4 multiply 1 by 4. Now you can simplify this, we will get the exact answer of this question, right? Now this type of question is very important in which you have one probability is given in the statement. You have to read the statement and write that probability. It may be impossible event, it may be sure event, right? Very good. Now, let's see one more question. From board examination. A car is gone. Very important question, very important. A car is drawn from a bag of 52 cards is lost. From the remaining card, from the remaining cards of the pack, two cards are drawn, and find the probability. Find the probability that the missing card is to be R. So first of all, we have to decide how many events are there. A card is drawn from a pack of 52 playing cards. What are the possibility from the first step? From the first step, four possibilities are there. So we have four events in this. A card is drawn from a pack of 52 playing cards. The card may be from the heart, the card may be from the diamond, the card may be from the spade, and the card may be from the club. So we have four events here. Event E1, Event E2, Event E3, and Event E4. First, the lost card from diamond, the lost card from spade, and the lost card from club. Hearts, diamonds, spades, clubs. Find the probability that the missing card is to be heart. Means we have to find the probability of even. Probability of even. And what is given in this? That will be event A. What is given in this? From the remaining cards of the pack, two cards are drawn and are found to be hard. Means selecting two hearts from the remaining card. This is called event A. What is event A? Event A is given. Remaining cards of the pack, two cards are drawn and are found to be hard. Means we have to select two hearts from the remaining cards. Selecting two hearts from the remaining card. This is called event A. And finally, we have to find the probability of even by A. And to find the probability of even by A, we must know about probability of even, probability of E2, probability of E3, probability of E4, as well as probability of A by E1, probability of A by E2, probability of A by E3, and probability of A by E4. If you know these 8 events, probability of these 8 events, you can find the probability of E1 by A. Now, E1, the lost card from the heart, means heart is lost, what is the probability of this? The lost car could be R. How many R's in 52? 13. So I think this probability will be 13 by 52. It will be 1 by 4. Probability of getting the lost card will be the diamond. There are 13 diamonds. 1 by 4. Again 1 by 4. Again 1 by 4. So probability of E1, E2, E3 and E4 are 1 by 4, 1 by 4, 1 by 4 and 1 by 4. And the very important part, the sum of all the 4 probability must be 1. The sum of all these two events, probability of these two events must be 1 here. But if E1, E2, E3 and E4, this sum must be 1, that, so it will be the exhaustive event. Now how can we find A by E1? What do you mean by probability of A by E1? A by E1 is probability of selecting two hearts when it is given that one heart is lost. Probability of selecting two hearts when it is given that one heart is lost. If one heart is lost, we have 51 cards. In which 12 are hard. How can we select the 12 card? 2 card. So there are 2 hearts. 12C2 divided by. We have to select 2 hearts from the remaining card if one heart is lost. So we have 12 hearts. And how many total cards are there? 51. It will be 51C2. This is the probability. Now A by E1. Selecting 2 hearts if one heart is lost. Now, what do you mean by A by E2? A by E2 means probability of selecting two hearts when a diamond is lost. Selecting two hearts when a diamond is lost. So, you can say that it will be 13C2 by 51C2. If one diamond is lost, means we have 13 hearts in this. So, how can we find a 2 heart from 13? 13C2 by 51C2 and the next one again 31C2 by 51C2. Again 31C2 by 51C2. Because if one heart is lost, one spirit is lost, the probability of getting 2 heart will be 13C2 by 51C2. Now we can apply the formula by Bayes' theorem E1 by A. We can apply the formula for E1 by A. We can write it as probability of E1 multiplied probability of A by E1 and divided by probability of E1 multiplied probability of A by E1 and plus probability of E2 multiplied probability of A by E2 and plus probability of E3 multiplied probability of A by E3 and plus probability of E4 multiplied probability of A by E4. Right? Now you can put these value after simplification of these, you will get the exact answer. Very important question, already asked 3 times in board examination. Right? Very important. So these are questions based on Bayes' theorem. In Bayes' theorem, you have to read the last line, what you have to find. If we have to find the probability of the event which is one of the events from the given events, so you can solve by the Bayes' theorem. Right? Now one more question we have, very important. One very important question from board examination and from NCERT also. A is known to speak truth 3 times out of 5 times. 3 times out of 5 times he throw the die and reports that it is 1. find the probability, find the probability that it is actually 1. Find the probability that it is actually 1. Right? Very important question. For 6 marks, A is a person, A is a person which is known to speak truth 3 times out of 5. So speak lie 2 times out of 5. He throws a die and report that it is a 1. He throws a die and report it is a 1. Find the probability that it is actually 1. Find the probability that it is actually 1. From find the probability, we can write 2 events here. Event E1 and event E2. Event E1, find the probability that it is actually 1. So, it is actually 1 or it is not 1. These are event E1 and E2. Find the probability that it is 1. So we can say that getting 1, you can write by this getting 1 and not getting 1. After throw a die, these are event E1 and E2. What is given? He throw a die and reports that it is 1. He reports that it is a 1. This is event A. We have to find probability of E1 by A. We have to find the probability of E1 by A. E1 by A, in the statement we can write the probability of getting 1 if he reports that it is actually 1. Find the probability of getting 1 if we report that it is actually 1, we have to find E1 by A. To find E1 by A, we need the probability of E1, the probability of E2, the probability of A by E1, and the probability of A by E2. We have to find these 4 events. After throwing a die, what is the probability of getting 1? 1 by 6. After throwing a die, what is the probability of not getting 1? 5 by 6, as sum of both the events must be 1. Now, what do you mean by A by E1? What do you mean by A by E1? Just transform in statement. A by E1 can be, A by E1 can be, the probability of he reports that it is 1 if it is actually 1. He reports that it is 1 if it is actually 1 means he speaks true. This is 3 by 5. And what do you mean by A by E2? In the statement A by E2 can be written as probability of he reports it is 1, he reports that it is 1, and if it is given that it is not 1. He reports that it is 1, but it is not 1, means he speaks lie, not true. So this probability is 2 by 5. If 3 times out of 5 times he speaks true, so 2 times out of 5 he speaks lie. Now we can apply the formula from Bayes' theorem. It will be E1 multiplied A by E1 divided by probability of E2 multiplied probability of A by E2 and plus probability of E1, A by E1, E2, A by E2. You can apply the formula, you will get 1 by 6 multiplied 3 by 5 divided by 1 by 6 multiplied 3 by 5 plus 5 by 6 multiplied 2 by 5. After simplification, you can cancel 6 by the 13 denominator 3 by 3 plus 10, it will be 3 by 13, exact probability, 3 by 13, right? This is the exact probability. Now we have to do one more question based on Bayes' theorem. One more question we have to Bayes' theorem. Very good from 2012 board examination. Suppose a girl throw a die. Suppose a girl throw a die. If she gets a 5 or 6, she tosses a coin 3 times and notes the number of heads. If she gets 1, 2, 3, or 4, she tosses a coin once and notes whether a head or tail is obtained. If she obtained exactly one head, what is the probability that she threw 1, 2, 3, or 4 with a die? Very important question. Just read the question. Suppose a girl threw a die. There are 2 events. The girl threw a die. Actually, this may be 6 events, but in this question, we have 2 events only. First event, she gets 5 or 6. And the second event, she tosses up. And the second event, she gets 1, 2, 3, or 4. So I think we have only 2 events in this. Even getting 5 or 6, and event E2, getting 1, 2, 3, or 4 after throwing a die. What is the probability that she throw 1, 2, 3 or 4 with a die? Which we have to find the probability E2. And what we have to give, if she obtained exactly one head, so what is event A? Obtaining exactly one head. This is called event A. Right. Now we have to find probability of E2 by A actually. What is the probability of C throw 1, 2, 3 or 4 if C obtained exactly one head? Which what we have to find finally. Finally we have to find probability of E2 by A. Finally we have to find this one. To find E2 by A, we need probability of E1, probability of E2, probability of A by E1 and probability of A by E2. We need these 4 events, right? First of all, find the probability of getting 5 or 6. 2 by 6, there are 2 numbers out of 6, it will be 1 by 3. What is the probability of getting E2? 4 by 6, it will be 2 by 3. And sum of both must be 1. Yeah, 1 by 3 plus 2 by 3, 3 will be 1. Now, what do we mean by A by E1? A by E1, according to statement, obtaining exactly 1 hit when he getting 5 or 6. Obtaining exactly 1 hit if he getting 5 or 6. If he getting 5 or 6, he tossing a coin 3 times. He tossing a coin 3 times. He tossing a coin 3 times. If he tossing a coin 3 times, what will get? HHH, HST, STX, STT, THH, THT, TTH and TTT. The question is, if she gets 5 or 6, she tosses a coin 3 times. If she tosses a coin 3 times, means we have a sample facing 8 elements. And what we have to find? Probability of obtaining exactly 1 head in this. Exactly one head. We have 3 events. So favorable outcome in 3 and a total outcome in 8. So A by E1 can be written as 3 by 8. Right? Now what do you mean by A by E2? Writing statement. A by E2 means obtaining exactly 1 head. If he getting 1, 2, 3 or 4, let's see the question. If she gets 1, 2, 3 or 4, she tosses a coin once. If she tosses a coin once, what is the probability of getting 1 head? 1 by 2 only. What is the probability of getting 1 head if we tosses a coin once? Right? This is called 1 by 2. Now we can find the probability of E2 by A. And the probability of E2 by A will be probability of E2 multiply probability of A by E2 and divided by the total probability. It will be probability of E1 multiply probability of A by E1 and plus probability of E2 multiply probability of A by E2. Right? Now you can put the values, you will get the answer. Probability of E2 2 by 3 multiply 1 by 2 divided by 1 by 3 multiply 3 by 8 plus 2 by 3 multiply 1 by 2. After simplifying, you will get the exact answer. Right? So now we discussed many problems based on Bayes theorem and total probability in this tutorial. Now you can solve each and every question related to probability. Now we have only two topics remaining, probability, which is the probability distribution and the binomial distribution, that we will discuss in the next tutorial. Thank you.